saw how much he was suffering at the beginning of lap number three. Seemed to come back a little bit. It's sort of broken his rhythm going into the penalty box. Perhaps taken just a little bit of confidence away from that. So although at the moment it looks very much like Alistair Brown and Javier Gomez for the gold and the silver medal, I think everything's okay for on the bronze. At least everything's okay for the bronze. It's not all over by any means.
Alistair Brown is on his way on the final lap. Less than 2.5 kilometres to run. With Javier Gomez in the second, the gap is now significant as they approach the outer back for the last time. Gomez just watching the man in black in front of him. And Jonathan Brownlee maintains his position in third. Looks to be more comfortable than he was before he entered the penalty box. A moment for Alistair to enjoy as he eyeballs Gomez behind him.
After that impromptu interview, thank you very much. Right in front of us, Nick Dempsey!
Welcome back to Weymouth for the finals of the RSX for women. The boards have just come out onto the race course. We are about to get underway in the next 10 minutes or so. The board, this one stacks up to be a brilliant regatta. It's close. John, you've had a little bit of points. It's not a foregone conclusion by any means.
No, it's not. It's 24 points after the 10 races. And Marina Alabau Neira from Spain is at the top of the tree. She actually had a first in the second, third and fourth races. She's had a couple of seconds, a couple of thirds. And she has discounted an eighth place. So total of 32, net points of 24. So that's the important number there, 24 after 10. This medal race coming up, of course, will be counting as double points, so the winner gets two. She will be there or thereabouts, and I think that they're really going to, she's going to have to sail badly, and the others are going to have to sail out of their skins to upset that. And just looking at that 14, she needs to sail worse than seventh place for anybody else to stand a chance. So in terms of the situation, as it stands before the medal race, Marina Alabau Neira of Spain is absolutely the favorite. We've just seen Lee Kozitz there of Israel and the supporters. She won the first race and she won the eighth race, discounted the sixth, which was an 11th place. She's got 38 points altogether. There she is, just resting up at the moment. And then the Finnish sailor of Tuuli Petaja. She had an eighth start, which a really bad start, and a seventh in the second race, discounted that first one. But she finished up the 10th race in first position. So she has got used to these conditions more and more as the week's gone on. She also shares that second position at 38 points. So two at 38 points, second and third. Moana Dell from Germany is on 39. Zofia Noceti-Klepacka from Poland is on 41. Ola Maslivitz on 44. And you have to say, Brownie Shaw, who was involved in Beijing in the medals, obviously is not quite out of the medal count here either. So although she's got 49, you'd have to say that was a real outside chance. I think it's going to be between, realistically, Poland, Germany, Finland and Israel for the minor placements and the minor medals, and Spain with Marina Alabau Neira will have to have a disastrous sail here not to take the gold. So it's all looking very good with less than 5 minutes now to the off. But and what is happening to the wind here at the moment?
Conditions-wise, it's lightened off a little bit. That rain squall came through. That caused a little bit of more wind earlier on. Wind out of 230, southwest. It's 12 knots, but I think it's 12 knots gusting to 14, 15. And in the rain, it might even get up a little bit more than that. We're in sequence. We're about to get the preparatory signal at 4 minutes. And we are in for 3 laps of the course. I saw LR3 on the board. The top mark is set at 230 degrees.
The sail area is just slightly smaller than the version for the men. The men sail at 9.5 square meters, the women at 8.5 square meters. And it looks like the wind is a little bit shifty. It's dropped certainly since this morning. We've had some rain. The umbrellas are not up now, but it's pretty chilly and it's quite uncomfortable there for the spectators. You can see they're looking at the triathlon in the background there.
The RSX for women, same board as the men, 2.86 metres, just 9.93 in the meanwhile. Sail area at 8.5 square metres. That's the difference with the men, just a square metre less. 3 minutes 15 to go to the start. And as we look at the points, John's gone through this with Alabau looking relatively clean as she can get off to a good start. And then it is all on for silver and bronze.
Would they have changed the mark between the first and the second race now, the men's race and the women's race?
No, I think the top mark might have been shifted a little bit more to the right. There certainly was a shift. Maslovitz from the Ukraine, and sitting there in sixth position. LR3 is the course. 3 laps of that windward lured. 2 minutes 36 to go to the start. The start is between the two orange poles. If you jump the start early, you've got a return. There's the race management team. They've done a fabulous job right through the Weymouth Regatta, London 2012. As we come up to 2:15 for the start. The women's RSX windsurfer.
Start for the
interesting. This is the last time we see windsurfing in the Olympics. How many of these sailors will transfer their skills into kiteboarding? I suspect a lot.
Yeah,
because they are racers and they're very good, they're intuitive, they're used to riding aboard. I think we will see a transfer of the talent over to the new kiteboarding. Interesting to see how that develops. That will replace the windsurfer as we come up to 1:36 is the third place getter at the moment.
I think you're absolutely right. I think in terms of potential, the kite surfing has definitely got that under wraps at the moment, because every time we go near the sea, I spend quite a lot of time down in Bali because my family were there for 4 years, and the noticeable difference between what is happening 4 years ago and what's happening now. It's full of kite surfers. There are not so many windsurfers.
I'd agree with that, and certainly I can reinforce that with Ireland and New Zealand. As we are now in the last minute, as on boards, this is RSX for women windsurfing, where the leading girl is
from
Spain, Marina Alabau Neira.
She's right up there on the left.
Yeah, right up against the boat. You can even back the boat and boards down. Amazing skill. Finland third, leading into this. 25 to go. Watch out for the extreme pumping off the line. They use the, as it's commonly called, air rowing with 15 to go. It's all going to break loose soon. This is the last race for the women's RSX windsurfer. Right down at the pin, reaching towards that pin end. She'll have a lot of speed on at the pin end as we hit the gun. It's a clean start for the fleet. It's a lovely start midline for GBR, but Ukraine really jumped off the line.
It certainly did. Ola Maslovich, she has a plan here. She's got a strategy. She's still not without a chance of getting a medal here. 44 points overall, just 6 points behind bronze medal position. So the Ukrainian girl really giving it a go.
try and keep a track as we go around the course of the points. Up to windward, it is Spain leading. There's Ukraine, just the speed differences on a board, if you get the time on distance right off the line, it's massive. And it is Ukraine, Ola Maslovich, launched off the line as we quickly then have a look at the point. She's on 44. She certainly can achieve as high as a silver if Maslovich can carry this one on. She's sixth currently, but she is only, she's close enough on points to get right up to, in my reckoning there, John, up to second.
She can.
If she can continue this good form.
Absolutely. She was also involved in the Olympics in Beijing and Athens and in Sydney. So this is her fourth Olympics. She's got the experience. She's actually been honoured as the national sports title of the Honoured Master of Sport. So she has been there and done it, and just look at her go at the moment. It was a brilliant, inspired movement behind the back of the fleet at the start line, and you could see the way she was coming so close to us.
Well, she came and hit that pin end at pace. Brilliant. Everyone else was stalled on the line, just waiting for a conservative start. Maslovich just put the hammer down, pin end, hit the line at 20 knots. And her opposition were really doing one or two knots at that windward end.
And she's 70 kilos, you know, so that will make a big difference. The girls ahead of her are all in the 50s. She is definitely, well, in fact, Lee Kozitz, the Israeli girl, is also 70 kilos. But they, between them, those two are the tops.
First tack by Ukraine, led off the line. Beautiful time on distance start. Now, the wind has lightened off. See how they're just now starting to struggle to plane. To keep on the plane as we look at shore to windward.
Really short, yep.
And down to load we've got.
She was actually holding on to the pull up rope there, yep, rather than the boom.
The uplift. That seems to be a bit of a technique. Using the backhand just to steer.
Yep.
But Ukraine are clear at the first cross. Put that one down to a beautiful start, and there does seem to be a little bit more pressure on this left hand side. Can see she's fully powered up and planing. The difference in speed, this is post-tack, so that's really slow, but the difference in speed could be as much as 3 or 4 knots in favour of Ukraine.
She's gone.
Maslovich, she's gone. She's launched. Now what we've got to keep a track of, where are the rest? Where are Israel, Finland and Germany and Poland? We'll maybe take a time check on that when they come around the top mark. We can see Poland and Finland. There's the regatta leader, Marina Alabau Neira.
That was an extraordinary start.
That was an extraordinary start, but really we've just got to get our head around at the first mark, who is positioned where. But one thing we can tell you, put this down to a courageous, a good time on distance start by Ola Maslovich from the Ukraine. She's currently in sixth position, but really putting herself in a chance to get up into medal contention.
Well, I can tell you now, if she goes on and wins this, she'll pick up 2 points, so that's 46 points. And then it's really just a question of looking at all the others around her. Maslovich has got to get them a better than third position. Mona Dell has got to do better than fourth. You know, there's so many ramifications from that perspective, but having someone coming from down in the pack really sets the catamounts
apart. It certainly does. It certainly does. As we look there, I think that is Shaw from GBR. She probably is out of medal contention with 49 points in seventh.
Unless she gets a second, you see, which will take her up to then, 53 points. Yeah, you're probably right.
Ukraine at the top mark. She did a little short tack there. Tacking is so expensive.
Slow. Yeah, slow.
Must have been a little bit of a wind shift as she just gets back on the pace. Maslovich from the Ukraine. Now, that huge lead she had with that little double tack she did was very costly. And that's bought.
She's very tight there.
No, but you're allowed to hit the mark on the board.
For sure, but it was too close for any speed.
And now she's speed board. Second is Shaw. Third looks to be right on the mark is the battle with Spain, Alabau. But Ukraine, after having a massive lead, underlaid the top mark, two short tacks, and the fleet really gobbled up a lot of her room. There's Cincini from Italy coming along. Alexander Cincini, gold medalist in Sydney 2000. Certainly went into this as one of the favourites, Cincini. So at Mark 1, it's Maslovic, Shaw, Alabau make up the first three.
Where is Lee Corsett?
There she is. She's deep in the field.
And this is going to be a disaster for her. 38. Let's have a look at her. Ooh, she's way back now.
So that's going to cost her. As
eighth place.
There's only two places behind her. As John quickly puts the pen and paper out.
We will do our
best to keep a track of these points. This one could be a bit more. This will challenge you.
Well, Lee Corsett, I tell you, is behind Brioni Shaw overall. After starting the race at second place, Brioni Shaw has moved up, and Lee Corsett is behind her. 1 point adrift. So
long way to go yet. We're only on the first lap. There's three laps of this Windward Lord course. As we look at the race, current race leader from the Ukraine, that is Maslovic. Ola Maslovic got a beautiful start at the pin end. She did. I think she made a little bit of an error of judgment at that top mark, doing two tacks down speed, and that brought Shaw right back into the game. Now Shaw is really challenging for the lead here in the middle race. Shaw positioned.
She's picked up
port starboard here. The rules are with Ukraine. Shaw jibes to windward as they come. That's the bottom mark. We're back at the bottom mark. In there by a board length is Ukraine. But Shaw has come back very strong on that downwind. Maslovic from Shaw. Then we've got Alabau Neira coming in from Spain. Next we've got Poland. Klepacka.
It was just 2 seconds at the boy there, but Maslovic was much quicker in picking up, and Shaw lost about 4 or 5 seconds on that particular pickup from that lead mark.
Just shows you how expensive it is if you get the lay lines wrong at the top mark for Maslovic, and at the bottom mark for Shaw, just a little bit, the angle not quite right.
Let's have a look at Tuuli Petaja. There she is from Finland, just going off at the top of your screen. The blue and white background across there. She was in third place with 38 points, but let's have a look at where she sits at the moment. She's way back off the pace in sixth place. Add 12 to that, so that gives her 50. Wow, 50 points. And Brioni Shaw at the moment sitting at 51. So
it's close, very close. But now Ukraine, because they got Maslovic, because she got the first little bit of freshening wind, has jumped away again from Shaw as they come up the Windward Beat. Oh, this is a disaster for the Israeli sailor.
Canada leaps up.
She's second to last because she's right down. Well, she's actually slipped back to.
That's extraordinary. She has such a great record. In the World Championship, she actually won.
Pressure.
In Cadiz.
It's about pressure, John. You're in middle races, you're under the pump.
Well, I mean, she's got so much experience, though, Peter. I mean, the Israeli girl was the world champion 2011 and 2012 in Perth and in Cadiz. I know, warmer waters. You don't need to tell me.
Yeah, I'll get on my soapbox again. But Marina Alabau Neira, she is set up here to be the Olympic champion. She put a great week together when we look at her score.
It's consistent.
She's enjoyed the conditions. Won three races, and then really her drop performance is an eighth. So it's that consistency of performance over the 10 races. Going upwind faster than the wind, or the same speed.
The same speed, yeah. 14,
amazing, isn't it?
14 knots.
They really are speed machines.
What a great picture that was.
We've got Spain, GBR. So the way it's stacking up now, the Olympic champions looking as though it will go to Spain with Marina Alabau Neira. But it's all on for Ukraine, who went into the medal race in sixth position.
She's up to second.
She could get up to second.
She is in second.
That is big. Ola Maslovic. She's having the race of her life. Beautiful start. Made a bit of an error at the top mark first time. I bet she doesn't do that this time, underlaying that top mark. Just a ley line judgment call. three laps, we're on the second lap.
We saw the graphic there with Tuuli Petaja from Finland in fourth place, supposedly, which means that gives her eighth place if it stays like that, and she will then 8 points, and she will then go up to 46 overall. And that means that Ola Maslovic will be just there or thereabouts. So if Petaja can continue with her fourth place at the moment, she may well have a chance to get certainly a medal, if not the silver.
Just having a little stop that lay line. Last time, Maslovic just didn't quite get that right. See, it's light at the top of the course. At the bottom of the course, it's fresh. It's around 12 to 15 knots. At the top, because it's sheltered by the breakwater of the harbour, it is tricky. And here we go. She's tacked. This is a better lay line for the young Ukrainian. She comes out. Maslovic leading at mark three. It's very tricky at the top of the course for the women's RSX windsurfer. Less wind means less speed. Less speed means you've got to pump more to get the board on the plane. But look how much she has extended as she comes down the downwind. But now here's another little error. Look at the series leader underlaid the mark. This will be expensive. Really short. It's going to take her at the mark. Because of this less wind, it means that the tacking angles are wider. Tacking angles wider means that has created a change for second place. Shaw picked the lay line, and it was Alabau Neira that got the lay line wrong.
She did, but the important thing there in that little tableau was that Tuuli Petaja from Finland has got up there as well. So if she continues with her fourth place, third place at the moment, that means she gets 6 points onto the 38, and that means that she is 44, and that will keep her in silver medal position. So very, very important.
So that was a
there.
That was a big moment for Petaja from Finland to get a point back. The Ukrainian girl is gone. Maslovic, she sailed a beautiful second leg. There's only one lap to go, but the mathematics,
she's got 46.
She's got 46. So right now, the update as they go down to the bottom mark is Alabau Neira. Marina Alabau Neira is
46.
Looking at gold. Yep. Then we've got Finland.
That with 30 points. That gold is with 30 at the
with
position
30.
At the moment. Yep.
Second, we will have Finland.
That's
and
how
then,
it is.
And then we will have Maslovic jumping up from sixth to third.
Yep.
But we'll just monitor that. We've still got a lap to go. And that'll all depend, John, on where Finland finishes overall.
Yep. If she drops another place, then it's all on again. Because at 44 at the moment in third, she drops another place, she drops back then big time, and it's 46 all. I'm going to have a look at the count back.
No, count back is the medal race. I know that one. I read the book.
Therefore.
And Ukraine now around the bottom mark, one lap to go.
She's in silver medal.
She has not put a step wrong. Spain second. Spain have got back. That's Alabau Neira. Marina Alabau Neira has actually got round in front of Ronnie Shaw on the downwind. There was a change in that position at the top of the course. So the Olympic champion still be to be decided, but it's looking very much like that. But Shaw
is out of it actually in terms of the overall. She's doing a great job in this medal round or medal race, but she's 55 points as she stands.
Fourth, we've got Finland.
Wow,
fourth is 8 points, and eight on to your total.
Yep, 46, which means that she's in bronze medal position.
Well, it's even.
But she's in bronze because of the Maslovic leader.
Right, because of Maslovic leader. So we've got the first three will be Spain.
Yep.
And then
Ukraine.
We've got Ukraine and then Finland. The way it's stacked up at that bottom mark.
And the biggest disappointment is Israel's lead, because it's world champion 2 years in a row, and she has
been out of it.
Blasted out of it.
She's out of it. Bad start. Bad first start. Would be this girl is having the race of her life. Maslovic beautiful start. The only little glitch she had was on the second windward beat, where she underlaid the top mark, but since then she hasn't put a foot wrong. Coming right out to the lay line. So we've got Maslovitz leading from Alabau Neira. Marina Alabau Neira from Spain. Fourth at the RSX Olympics in Beijing. So this is a step up. Nice and consistent. Third in 2011. Actually, she had a bad Worlds in Cadiz. She was 13th. So to come up and be Olympic champion from Spain, this would be a big result for Alabau Neira, 26-year-old from Seville.
So Ukraine really cruising it at the moment, and well, what a thing to be able to say that you won the last Olympic race in the RSX category, because that's what it is at the moment, although there is some chat about trying to get it back on schedule for Rio. At the moment, it's not going to happen.
No, definitely. The decision has essentially been made. There's lots of politicking going on, but there's a cross with Finland. Now that's a place back for her, for Finland, so that's going to again give your pen another go at the top mark.
Now it's very much a situation of Spain first with Neira, but we're now talking overall, of course, not just for the race here.
There's Matala, the laser radio sailor watching from Finland, watching her. I'm sure her best friend from Finland is
ninth place.
Just if that happens, Alabau Neira destined for gold overall. If you're wondering what the small apparatus right on the nose cone of the board, that's the GPS tracker. It gives us our animation. As we look at the style of the champion heading upwind, a little bit less power than the men's RSX, a little less horsepower. The wind is really getting quiet at the top of the mark. We can see they're having to pump. As the wind decreases, then the sailors get into this pumping action. You can see the board now just struggling to get up on the plane. That means that the physicality increases to keep the board moving. Just about off the plane as Maslovitz coming into the top mark. A little bit of wind on the water there. You can see the darker green spot. She'll take the board right past the lay line. Pretty important that she holds on to first here if she's going to pick up a medal. She doesn't want to get run down on the downwind by Alabau Neira.
Well, the situation is that she can't afford to lose that first place. She will not get the medal if she doesn't hold on to first.
Comfortable lead at the moment, but look, it's Alabau Neira really coming back into it, and it's downwind that's going to be tricky because there's not much wind at the top mark, and it doesn't take much of an increase in wind if one of the boards starts planing, and if Alabau Neira can get on a bit of a roll, she'll chop this lead to bits.
Can I tell you something here though, Peter, that the interesting thing is that the British girl, GBR girl, Brioni Shaw, is doing Maslovitz a huge favour. Because she's holding third place at the moment, that means she's giving her a chance to level the scores with Petaja, who is behind her. So Brioni Shaw is the thorn in the side of Petaja from Finland, but actually, she is the guardian angel of Maslovitz.
It's right here now, though.
And the Klepacka has come in.
They're very close. It's going to come down.
Klepacka has definitely confirmed issues here. Now, let's have a look at that. Wow, this
is
interesting.
You work on that.
I will.
There's been a big change in the third windward beat. It's still Ukraine in the lead, but behind it is Klepacka, the Polish sailor. She had a beautiful downwind. Third windward beat.
Klepacka needs to get up one more place and she could get a medal. As she stays as it is, she adds 6 points to her tally, and that means she's in 47 points. At the moment, Pataha is 46, Maslovitz 46, but she's in the lead, so she'll take it because she's actually got the medal round victory in her sights. So it's at the moment, it's Marina Alabau of Spain with the gold in her sights. it will be Ola Maslovits of Ukraine, who's moved up really, really well up by winning this, or potentially winning this one, from sixth right up to silver medal position. Tuuli Petaja from Finland in third place, and Klepacka is only just a little behind her. That is quite remarkable. Just look at this, and Spain look as if they've taken over. Wow. Is that how it is?
Well, we need to go back. We're on the graphic. There's the flags of the Spanish team. Spain, she's in pressure. See, as they've come down, remember at the top of the course, yep, there was very little wind.
Yep.
If one of the board sailors picks up the increase in wind, the speed jumps up. So she is in the lead.
So Maslovits is out of it there.
Maslovits, she's lost it on the last leg. My, as we have at the bottom mark, the Olympic champion coming around the bottom mark, heading towards the finish. So that's Marina Alabau Neira heading towards the finish. And in getting round Ola Maslovits, I think that will deprive the young Ukrainian sailor of a medal. But there's your Olympic champion. It is Marina Alabau Neira from Spain, takes the gold medal.
It's really getting very, very tight here. Let's have a look. Ukraine, I think that she might still be able to hold on to a bronze medal here, but it looks like Petaja got it. But Ukraine coming in second position overall, so that is 48 points for her overall. There she is. Oh, what a disastrous final leg. She was in the lead from go, but then ultimately she's still done a great job. But let's look at the pole coming through here. Poland coming through with Klepacka, and if she gets third place, that means altogether she's got 47 points, and there she goes through, and she will be celebrating a medal. Look at that. She will definitely get a medal, and it may be even now that Petaja, and it will be Petaja, who goes out of it because of this intervention of Brioni Shaw from Great Britain, Germany as well. Where is the Finn? Tuuli Petaja. It means that she's been sailed out of it. So at the moment, I think we've got Spain, we've got Klepacka, and Ola Maslovits. I don't know. Let's see whether or not that is confirmed. Ooh, I'm not sure. It's Petaja, who did come in fourth place. We missed her on the line.
We'll just wait for that to be confirmed. But certainly the last downwind, the boards went down the top mark as we look there at from Italy coming over the line as the boards come through. But what there, look at that lovely shot. We have Marina Alabau Neira celebrating, Olympic champion here in Weymouth. As the through comes the Israeli sailor. Gorsitz, what a disappointment for her. Went into the middle race in second position. Didn't have a good start. Your first win would be.
Okay, I can tell you, Peter, I've just done a little bit of maths, and we've got first place Spain. That was undisputed. We've got second place at the moment with Tuuli Petaja from Finland, and in third place Zofia Noceti-Klepacka, because it's 26 points v 46 points v 47 points. And Ola Maslovits, after leading throughout, just on the last leg, came into second place overall, and she will remain in fourth place with 48. That really is a disappointment for her.
It's cruel, but the game, enjoy the pitches.
Yeah, the girl there from Spain really, really celebrating a magnificent victory. From Sevilla in Spain, Finland, does she know? She was in third place, and I've got a feeling, looking at the scores, at 46. That is still be confirmed. That is unofficial. I think she's got a silver medal. They don't know that yet. It's still got to be worked out, but I can tell you, when they do find out that they've got a silver, they are going to be jumping here on the nose. You can help me confirm it. 38 points, and she.
I had a quick look at the points, John, and I'm with you. That is still to be confirmed. But one thing we do know is that Marina Alabau Neira has taken gold. She is the Olympic champion on the RSX.
There she knows it now. There you go. brilliant. She heard it on the radio, and that is second place for Tuuli Petaja because Ola Maslovic lost the lead.
Wonderful effort. Good mathematics by John Burgess sitting next to me, ex-school teacher. I'm a bit scared to sit next to him, actually, as we look at the Olympic champion again. Wow. Wonderful, wonderful effort. What a week for Alabau Neira, the 26-year-old from Seville.
That's the individual points then for this medal race. Spain at the top. What a way to finish. We've had the leaders going into the medal race, winning both the men's and now the women's race. And that is a most magnificent way to say goodbye.
It is the last time we see RSX windsurfing in the Olympics. But I would almost guarantee we will see these. So there's the finish flag. And it took a while for
she didn't realize Petaja it.
To be told that she was second overall. Silver medalist in the RSX windsurfer class.
Well, that the big disappointment is Maslovic there, obviously, on the day. But even much more of a disappointment was Lee Kozic from Israel, who had started the day in second place and was just absolutely out of it with that bad finish. But the girl from Sevilla celebrates. Well done, Spain.